How can we keep from singing? This glorious hymn most wonderfully pictures the joy of the Christian faith. The experience of the Christian should not be an evanescent one. Outwardly, he may have the same sorrows as others, but inwardly, he has the peace of God which passes all understanding, ruling in his heart. It is like living in a new world, wherein the clamor of the present times is indeed heard, but not so much heeded, because he hears the ringing of the music of the new dispensation. The Christian's heart is with his Lord. His expectations are not for earthly wealth or fame, but for kingdom glory, honor, privileges, and services. Even now, he rejoices in his wonderful opportunities for serving. He is an ambassador for Christ, a representative of the coming kingdom, a finger post, a director for those who are feeling after God and wishing to be in harmony with him. As years go by, the Christian's experiences, if they are proper ones, grow richer and richer. Earthly joys and comforts may be taken away to prove his faithfulness and loyalty to God. But the fact that he is still in relationship to the Father and the Son is a source of continuous pleasure. It offsets all his losses. His faith grows stronger under trial. His inward calm is the more serene. He looks forward trustingly, realizing his master to be the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He feels like singing, yea, often like shouting, though filled with deeds of the Spirit, a sense of the divine presence. The apostle admonishes, set your affections on things above and not on things of the earth, and his thought is in it near the close of his hymn. As we lift our eyes more and more to the heavenly things, the intervening clouds become less and less, and the realities of the future life deepen their impression upon us. The pathway so rugged and narrow gradually smooths as the child of God gets a firmer hold upon his old nature and brings it into subjection to the new mind. He learns to love the narrow way, not merely because of the glorious outcome at his further end, when he will be received into his Father's house on high, but also because of present privileges of service in this way. The storms of life, its sorrows, its fears, do not penetrate so deeply as once they did. They are counted as light afflictions. All things are mine since I am his, the Christian joyfully sings. The development of the Church of Christ is the great work of God for the present age. All the powers of heaven are enlisted. Soon, however, the great work of blessing the world will begin, for the millennial age is already dawning.